Okay, students, now I've come up to the next part of your S block elements chapter. So in this video I'll again continue with the trends in the physical properties. Okay, so in the last video I've done till ionization enthalpy. In this video I'll start with electronegativity. Okay, so we all know that across a period, electronegativity, I'll write in short, okay? Across a period, electronegativity increases and down a group, electronegativity decreases. Means what happens across a period? Across a period, as the atomic radii decreases, so the Z effective on the outer electrons increases and the incoming electron faces a greater effective nuclear charge. So the atoms have a tendency to accept electrons, to attract electrons towards itself. So electronegativity increases across a period, and down the group what happens? The atomic radii increases. And when the atomic radii increases, the outer electrons are not strongly pulled by the nucleus. And so the incoming electron will not face a greater effective nuclear charge. So the tendency of the atoms to accept electrons decreases. As a result, electronegativity decreases down the group. So the electronegativity trend will be electronegativity is greatest for beryllium, then magnesium, then calcium, then strontium, then barium. Okay, next is electron gain enthalpy. You know that this group 2 elements have an outer electronic configuration of NS2, which means they have a stable outer electronic configuration, so they have very little tendency to accept electrons, very little tendency to accept electrons. Electron gain enthalpy is the next property. So since they have a stable outer electronic configuration of NS2, so they have very little tendency to accept electrons, because they are having stable electronic configuration. Because if they accept another electron, then that electron will be added to NP subshell, and that will have an electronic configuration of NS2NP1, which is not at all stable. So they have very little tendency to accept electrons, and their electron gain enthalpy value is very low. And we all know that as we move down the group, the electron gain enthalpy value decreases. So the electron gain enthalpy order will also be this. Okay, now I'll come to the flame coloration. You all know that alkali metals, by now you all know that the alkali metals show color in flames. The alkaline earth metals will also show color in the flame test, but there are certain exceptions. You know that what happens in flame, that the atoms absorb the energy from the flame and electrons are excited to the higher energy state when they emit radiation in order to come back to the lower state. That radiation falls in the visible region and gives different color depending on the frequency of this radiation. We will see different colors for different metals. Okay, so in this case calcium shows a color of brick red, strontium shows a color of crimson red, and barium shows a color of green. But what happens for magnesium and beryllium? Magnesium and beryllium will not show color in the flame test. Why? Because magnesium and beryllium have the highest ionization enthalpy among the alkaline earth metals. As we move down the group, the ionization enthalpy decreases. So they will have the highest ionization enthalpy in the group of alkaline earth metals. And since they are having high ionization enthalpy, so the energy of the flame is not enough to excite electron from electron of beryllium and magnesium to higher energy state. Means they are having high ionization enthalpy, means they will require higher energy to remove an electron. So the energy of the flame is not enough to excite an electron, means the energy of the flame is less than their energy of the flame is less than their ionization enthalpy value. So that energy of the flame is not enough to excite an electron of beryllium and magnesium to the higher energy state. So they do not show color in the flame test. Okay, now I'll come to the next property, which is color and magnetic properties. You all have seen that they have an outer electronic configuration of NS2, means diamagnetic in nature. The electronic configuration, for example, if I take electronic configuration of magnesium, 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2. See, s orbital completely filled with 2 electrons. 2s orbital completely filled with 2 electrons. 2p orbital completely filled with 6 electrons. 3s orbital completely filled with 2 electrons. So all the orbitals are completely filled. And when the orbitals are completely filled, all the electrons are paired. There is absence of unpaired electron. So all the alkaline earth metals are diamagnetic. And hence they are colorless. Okay, now I'll come to the next property, which is the solubility of the compounds of the alkaline earth metals. Solubility of the compounds of the alkaline earth metals. Okay, now solubility depends on 2 factors. One is lattice energy. I have explained lattice and hydration energy in the previous video. Means for when I was teaching for S block elements. So solubility depends on 2 factors. One is the lattice energy and the second is the hydration energy. Now lattice energy is inversely proportional to solubility, and hydration energy is directly proportional to solubility. Means if the lattice energy is more, then solubility is less, and if lattice energy is less, then solubility is more. For hydration energy, if hydration energy is more, then solubility is more. If hydration energy decreases, then solubility also decreases. Okay, now I'll come to two types of compounds. Among them, number one, carbonates and sulfates. The solubility of carbonates and sulfates of the alkaline earth metals. Look at the anion carbonate and sulfate. They are of bigger size, bigger sized anions. Carbonates and sulfates are bigger sized anions. So they cannot match well with the comparatively smaller sized cations. The cations Ba2+, Be2+, Mg2+, Ca2+ have much lesser ionic radii as compared to carbonate and sulfate radicals. Okay, so in these cases, for the carbonates and sulfates, the lattice energy factor remains constant. Why the lattice energy factor remains constant? Because there is mismatch of the size of the cations and anions. The cations and anions are not of comparable sizes, so the lattice energy factor remains constant. Here the solubility solely depends on the hydration energy. The solubility of the carbonates and sulfates solely depends on the hydration energy. See, as we move down the group, the size of the cations increases. As the size of the cations increases, the hydration energy decreases. As the size of the cations increases, the hydration energy decreases. So, on moving from beryllium 2 plus to barium 2 plus, the size of the cation increases. As a result, the hydration energy decreases. So, as we move down the group, the carbonates and sulfate salts of alkaline earth metals, the solubility of carbonate and sulfate salts of alkaline earth metals decreases down the group. The solubility of the carbonates and sulfates of alkaline earth metals decreases down the group. Okay, now I'll come to the next type of compounds, which is hydroxides. The size of the hydroxide is comparable to that of the cations of the alkaline earth metals. So here the sizes of cations and anion is comparable. As the sizes are comparable, so here lattice energy comes into existence. Here the solubility completely depends on the lattice energy. And now lattice energy means it completely depends on the solubility completely depends on the lattice energy. Also remember one thing, as we move down the group, the size of the cations increases. And with the increase in the size of the cations, the lattice energy will decrease. With increase in the size of the cations, the lattice energy will decrease. And what I have shown you, that if lattice energy decreases, the solubility will increase. So on moving down the group, the lattice energy of the hydroxides of alkaline earth metals decreases. And when the lattice energy decreases, the solubility increases. So the solubility of the carbonates and sulfates decreases down the group, but the solubility of the hydroxides increases on moving down the group. Okay, so this is all about the physical properties, means strengths of physical properties of the alkaline earth metals. Means these all are most important. The other just existence and all those are not required. From the next video, I'll start with the chemical trends. Okay, thank you.